Hello, my name is Tan. I am an artist and performer living in Los Angeles, and I'm also a big music fan and K-pop fan, and I have been reacting to Tan, the K-pop group. I wanted to check them out because they have the same name as me, and then I discovered that I love their music, so right now I'm going to do an album reaction to their first EP, what's the title? Limited Edition One Tan, which has the title track Do do do. So yeah, I'm gonna listen to all the songs right now and just give you my opinion. Just off of first impressions, I noticed that there's a song called My Girl for Fan. So is that like their fandom? So does that mean that they don't expect to have fanboys? Am I allowed to be a fanboy of this group? I did notice one of their music videos was a little. So you gotta let the gaze in, I'm sorry. It comes with the territory. And I also noticed there's a do-do-do English version, which I am really excited for because not a lot of groups debut with English tracks. That's pretty dope. So the first song is called Fix You Part 1. Looks like it is some kind of intro track. I'm gonna listen to that. I have lyrics up. Let's go. I love these big reverberant drums. Did I just get rippled? Wow, okay. Initial thoughts. Who is the songwriters in this? One of the members wrote some lyrics, which is cool. This was a very short song, so I'm just gonna like give my thoughts very briefly, but I like that they always surprise you with the beat drop. This is the second time. It happened to me as well with Walking on the Moon, where all of a sudden you think it's gonna be like a bit slower, but then it goes double time. Very, very fun. And I was waiting for the chorus because the build-up felt very, like, kind of stereotypical build-up to a pop song. But then the chorus is just really, really beautiful. I didn't talk about it enough in my last reaction, but they have great vocals. So, love to see it. Really enjoyed it. And I wonder if they're going to... It says part one. I'm assuming probably one or two more parts in subsequent releases. I'm curious because Stray Kids have this thing where their first three EPs, all the EPs it was like a trilogy, and every intro song was like a third of a song that ended up going on the third EP. So I'm wondering if they're doing something like that. In that case, they wrote basically three different songs and then used the instrumental for the final song, but it was totally different lyrics. So I wonder if it's something like that, but I'm very, very curious. Sounds really interesting. Next up is Do Do Do, which I already know that I love, and now I get to just jam out to it. Let's go. I wanted to say this in my last reaction, but when the bass line drops and it says bass line, it's just so good because it's like, okay, it's good. Turn off your phone. I don't need to move to school, the airplane mode. You choose, make a way so cold. fucking Soylent. Whoever sang that line killed it. I keep wanting to sing it. I think I'm in Korean. Okay, so obviously I've reacted to this before, you know, kind of like Sam and Pain's I Love the Song. Very unexpected the way that they've used the acapella do 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 throughout the song is just like, mwah, it's so good. But I did notice, okay, so when I reacted to it the first time, I was confused because the bridge like didn't seem to happen. And on the Genius lyrics, it pretty much confirmed this for me. The rap is called verse 3, and then there's the interlude, which is the do-do-do, and then the final chorus and post-chorus, and then outro. So I was right, that song doesn't have a bridge, which is like a pretty bold move for like a debut song, I think. Also, I forgot to like just talk about the fact that this is their debut song. Like, what a brilliant debut. Debut songs are hard because it's like, it's gonna follow you forever, and it sets the tone for your group, but also you're not a seasoned group yet, so there are going to be some gaps in like your identity or what you want your sound to be. Yeah, so it can be difficult to just like come out with a debut and like have it be like all that pressure on this one song. And they came out with a really good song. I think like if I had heard this first, I still would have had the same exact impression as I had for Louder, because it's just a great song and not necessarily something seen a lot in K-pop. To that note, I think Louder was like a great follow-up because it showed that they could do a different genre, a very popular genre, and still do it in their own style. So yeah, now we are going to go to the last song, which is My Girl for Fan. My expectation off the bat is probably like maybe something more ballad. I can't imagine it would be like a straight banger. Ballad's very much a K-pop staple and it's a fan song, it seems. And also my brain can't help but think, but My Girl, which I believe is the Temptations. The Temptations. The OG boy group, like legit, they're the OG boy group. That would be cool if there was a nod to that, just as like a nerdy music fan, but I'm not expecting that. But if this ends up being like a doo-wop song, that would be so cool. I'm gonna stop expecting so much and just move on. Okay, feels very syncopated. Oh, okay, very 90s like boy band, which is interesting. So 90s. Oh my god. Didn't snap. Okay, so interesting. Do I feel a little bit vindicated for pointing out the Temptations as the OG boy group and then it was directly a boy group song? Just like, how do I say this? The second generation of boy groups? Like, I feel like the first was like doo-wop, like 50s era of boy groups, and then we had another surge in the 90s and early 2000s, and now we're having like the Hallyu K-wave surge of boy groups and girl groups. So yeah, interesting, probably just a coincidence that it ended up being like a nostalgic boy group song. But yeah, it definitely felt like something I would have heard like Y2K, but admittedly, probably on the Disney Channel. I think probably the person I would say it sounds like is Jesse McCartney. I could see him doing a song like this. So yeah, that's what I get from it. Doesn't seem to have any writing credits to the members. Okay, yeah, that was fine. And now, English version. I'm curious because some of the English lyrics in My Girl were not correct. I'm fall in you, I always you. Those aren't like full sentences in English. I am not someone who cares about correct English lyrics in K-pop. I don't care. But when people do English language songs, obviously I want them to be sensical so that I can like super rock out to them and not just be like, what are they saying? So for that reason, I hope that the lyrics make sense, because I was saying while I was reacting to Do 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 that I want so badly to sing along. So if I can sing along to this song, I'll be so stoked. And also thank you, Tan, for making, it's so weird because it's my name. Thank you to all nations for making your title tracks in English. I think that's really, really dope. Do Do Do, English version. Okay. So far the same. Girl, I got your love been dripping on me, keep running. Who's running? It's like an ocean in my heart. Girl, your eyes look like they want some more attention. Let me spend some time with them. Who's them? Lyrics are different. Wait a second. This is different. Was this in the Korean lyrics? I won't put it back the way I found it. Take my money. Show and prove. We can go to the moon, just cruising. We gonna be how you want. You wanna piss on me, girl? Hey, look at me, I'm free. You my queen. Yeah, everything will be fine with you. I'm a queen. I have so many thoughts. First of all, I have to bring up the translation of the Korean lyrics, because they weren't that explicit. Okay. They didn't translate it one to one. Okay, this answers my question. They did a great job. First of all, they did a great job of doing a song in English. Obviously, songwriters on one song is not going to equal whoever translated do do do, so I didn't need to be worried. They did a great job with this song. They didn't translate it directly, which I think is the best way to go. But I am curious, do the writing credits change? This is like my favorite hobby, so getting to do this and share it with people is cool. So if you're enjoying this, please let me know because I love doing it. Okay, I think I see. It was written by English composers, but it seems to me they actually did it in reverse. They wrote the English song because it says that the writers, composers, and lyricists for the English version are all the same people. And then Jisung from Tan is also credited on both versions. But the lyricists for the Korean version are just Juwon, Jaejoon, and Jisung. So I guess they got the English song in English and then they rewrote the lyrics for the Korean version. Very interesting, very cool. That's definitely one way to do it, and I think it's rad. So shout out to the songwriters. You did an amazing job. I really like the song. And then I'm also really impressed with how good their English sounded. Like, our rapper Jisung, I believe, did his rap in English. Sounded great. And he has writing credits on both versions, which makes me think that he also wrote his English rap, so is he an English speaker? I'm curious. That was really, really fun. I really enjoyed reacting to all these songs. I was kind of nervous doing an album reaction because I've never done one before, but I had a lot of fun. I had a lot to say, and I want to do more of these. I want to do one for each of their albums. If you want to see that, please subscribe. If you enjoyed this, please leave a like. What's your favorite song on the album? What do you want me to know? I've heard that they have a survival show, so I want to watch that. I'm not sure if I'm going to react to it or if I'm just going to watch it separately because I have a lot of video ideas, so it just really depends on like time and stuff. Thank you so much for watching. Have an amazing day, evening, morning, afternoon.